Bonjour aux étudiants de la 9e classe. Aujourd'hui, on va prendre une nouvelle leçon de votre texte qui s'appelle À la plage. Good day to the 9th standard students. Today, we're taking up a new lesson, which is the 6th lesson from your textbook. It's called À la plage, which is at the beach. Nous sommes enfin arrivés à 7 après une dure journée de voiture. À la plage, nous allons nous reposer au soleil. Nous baigner, nous amuser. So we have finally arrived at Sète. Now Sète is a seaside town in France. You can see the picture below. After a difficult journey or a hard journey by car. At the beach, we are going to sit in the sun, bathe or swim, and enjoy ourselves. These are all reflexive verbs. And allons reposer, you can also see the future proche being used. Je préfère me jeter dans les vagues. Bien sûr, il faut faire attention. Si l'on va trop loin du rivage, on risque de se noyer. So the author says, I prefer to jump in the waves. Les vagues are the waves. Very well, though, it is necessary to pay attention or to be careful. If one goes too far from the shore, one risks drowning themselves. Again, you can see me jeter, se noyer, these are reflexive verbs. Mais la mer Méditerranée est généralement assez calme et on peut se baigner sans danger. But the Mediterranean Sea is generally pretty calm and one can bathe without danger. Sans danger is without danger or safely. Généralement is an adverb. You can see it ending with ment. It's an adverb. Ce matin, je me suis levé, habillé, brossé les dents et nous nous sommes allés directement à la plage. This morning, I got up. I got dressed, I brushed my teeth, and we went directly or straight to the beach. Now here you can see the reflexive verbs. Se lever, s'habiller, se brosser, they are used in the passé composé. Quand nous sommes arrivés, maman me dit certaines choses. Ne t'éloigne pas du rivage, ne te baigne pas avec tes vêtements, ne t'allonge pas au soleil sans crème solaire. So when we arrived, Mama told me certain things. That M apostrophe is the direct object for me. Now, in the box, you can see Mama's speech is all in the... they are all reflexive verbs, but they are used in the negative imperative tense. So do not go too far from the shore. Do not bathe with your clothes on. And do not lay in the sun without putting sunscreen. En plus de cela, elle m'a ordonné, sèche-toi. Mets-toi de la crème, rhabille-toi pour aller en vie. In addition to this, she also ordered me. Now these words, these sentences, you can see they are in the, they are the reflexive verbs, but they are in the positive imperative tense. So dry yourself, put on yourself some cream, and dress yourself up, because we are going into the city. Quand ils vont à la plage, mes parents ne font rien. Ils s'allongent sur le sable et ils bronzent. Et ma grand-mère s'occupe avec un livre ou des mots croisés. When they go to the beach, my parents do nothing. Now this ne plus verb plus rien is an important construction which means nothing. They lay on the sand and they tan. And my grandmother occupies herself. S'occuper is again a reflexive. Occupies herself with a book or crossword puzzles. Mais moi, j'aime m'amuser. Il va être difficile pour moi de me remettre à étudier en septembre. But for me, I like to enjoy myself. It's going to be very difficult for me to return back to studying in September. Me remettre, m'amuser. Again, reflexive verbs. C'est la fin de la leçon. On espère que vous avez compris cette unité. Merci beaucoup. That's the end of this lesson. I hope you've understood this unit. Thank you very much.